Farewell to the groves of shillelagh and shamrock. Farewell to the girls of old Ireland all around. May their hearts be as merry as ever you could find them, as far away o'er the ocean I am bound. For me mother is old and me father quite feeble, to leave their own country it grieves their hearts full sore. Oh, the tears down their cheeks in great drops they are rolling, to think they must die upon a foreign shore. So it's pack up your sea stores, consider no longer, for $10 a week is not very bad pay, with no taxes nor ties to devour up your wages. When you're on the green fields of America,
it sails at a half an hour to cross the broad Atlantic. My friends are standing on the pier in grief and sorrow frantic. My trunks are all stowed down below the good ship Dan O'Leary. The anchor's weighed, the gangway's up, I'm leaving Tipperary. So it's goodbye Mick and it's goodbye Pat till it's goodbye Kate and Mary. The anchor's weighed, the gangway's up, I'm leaving Tipperary. See, there's the steamer blazing up, I can no longer stay, for I'm bound for New York City, boys, 3,000 miles away. My portmanteau, it is all packed with potatoes, greens and bacon. If you don't think I look after that, it's rude, you are mistaken. I'm deep in love with Molly Burke as a jackass is in clover. When I get settled, if she will come, I'll pay her passage over. So it's goodbye Mick and it's goodbye Pat and it's goodbye Kate and Mary. The anchor's way, the gangway's up, I'm leaving Tipperary. See, there's a steamer blazing up, I can no longer stay, for I'm bound for New York City, boys, 3,000 miles away.
I'm a decent boy just landed from the town of Ballyfad. Oh, I want a situation and I want it mighty bad. A position I saw advertised, 'tis the thing for me, says I, with a dirty spalpeen ended with no Irish need apply. Oh, says I, but that's an insult, but to get this place I'll try. So I went to see that blackguard with no Irish need apply. Well, some may think it a misfortune to be christened Pat or Dan, but to me it is an honour to be born an Irishman. Well, I couldn't stand his nonsense, so a hold of him I took, and I gave him such a baiting as he'd get in Donnybrook. And he hollered me a murder, and to get away did try, and he swore he'd never write again, no Irish need apply. He made a big apology, and I bid him then goodbye, saying, when next you want a baiting, write no Irish need apply. Well, some may think it a misfortune to be christened Pat or Dan, but to me it is an honour to be born an Irishman. Sure, I've heard that in America it always is the plan, that an Irishman is just as good as any other man. A home and hospitality they never will deny to strangers here or ever say, no Irish need apply. Ah, but some black sheep are in the flock, a dirty lot, says I. A decent man will never write, no Irish need apply. Well, some may think it a misfortune to be christened Pat or Dan, but to me it is an honour to be born an Irishman.
I am a rambling Irishman, I've travelled this country o'er. I formed a resolution for to leave my native shore, with a knapsack on me shoulder and a blackthorn in me hand. I headed for America like a rambling Irishman. When I landed in Philadelphia, the girls all jumped for joy. Said one unto the other, now there goes an Irish boy. They invited me to dine with them, they took me by the hand. The very first toast they all drank round was good luck to the Irish man.
When I came to this wonderful country, to complain I'd no reason at all. And being in very good humour, I often sang Erin-go-bra. And I learned for to be very handy, to use both the hammer and spade. I learned the fine art of canallin', and I find it an excellent trade. So fare ye well, father and mother, and likewise old Ireland too. And fare ye well, sister and brother, so fondly I'll bid you adieu. We had money in every pocket, there was nothing our minds to enthrall. I could handle a sprig of shillelagh with the best man upon the canal. And at night we'd all rest from our labour, we were sure that our rent was all paid. We'd lay down the hammer and shovel, and likewise the pick and the spade. So fare ye well, father and mother, and likewise old Ireland too. And fare ye well, sister and brother, so fondly I'll bid you adieu.
I am a bold hodman, I live by me trade. I mix up me mortar with hoe and with spade, and I climb up the ladder, though ever so tall, when the men of the trowel for mortar do call.
Toor-a-loo, toor-a-lay, we're building the city by night and by day.
As I stand on the scaffold with hod be me side, I cast my eyes home o'er the deep rolling tide. With a heart light and cheerful, I whistle and sing, like a lark in the morn as she mounts on the wing.
Toor-a-loo, toor-a-lay, we're building the city by night and by day.
Thank you.
3 weeks ago last Tuesday, well, I left me home in Cork to find me Uncle Martin Kelly living in New York. Well, I landed in Hoboken and began without delay to find me uncle's residence located in Broadway. I went to the directory me uncle for to find, but I found so many Kellys there that I nearly lost me mind. Well, I went and asked directions from a friendly German Jew, but he says, please excuse me, but me name is Kelly too.
And there's Kelly the barman, Kelly the carman, Kelly the sailor who came from Donegal, Kelly from Derry, Kelly from Kerry, but the Kelly I was looking for I could not find at all.
I travelled up to Boston, that city of great fame. I'd heard the Kellys living there had made themselves a name. The Kellys run the state house, the Kellys run the banks, the police and fire department, should the Kellys fill the ranks. Dan Kelly runs the railroads, John Kelly runs the seas, Kate Kelly runs the suffragettes, and she looks right good to me. Well, I went and asked directions from a naturalized Chinese, but he says, please excuse me, but me name it is Kelly.
And there's Kelly from Dublin, Kelly from Sligo, little Mickey Kelly, you came from the County Clare. Sure, Kelly built the pyramids with good old Galway granite, and when Kelly discovered the North Pole, sure he found that Kelly there.
Sergeant said, look here, me boy, we need you in the fight. So Tim put on his uniform and he started with the bang. And as he galloped down the street, his friends stood up and sang.
Sure, he's a likeable, lovable elite from Ladley, he comes from Meldrum Kieran, and he's wearing the stripes his daddy did, and there's no man he'll be fearing, for he's off to join the colours of the fight in 69. So cheer the lovable elite from Ladley as he marches up the line.
Through the winning pass for good old Notre Dame, we're in the lead in fighting speed when the army made its claim. He made the final point and says, I must uphold the name. We switched from one and the fun's begun, but it's Irish just the same.
For he's a rootin' tootin' shootin' lad, he's never fired a rifle with his hustle and his muscle, sure he's sure to be a knifeful as he marches past the stands again on Mick St. Patrick's Day. But they have no fear and you'll hear them cheer as they loudly shout array. For he's a likeable, lovable soldier boy, and he comes from Elroscommon, and he's wearing the stripes his daddy did, and he's off to stop the bombing, and he's off to join the colours of the fight in 69. So cheer the lovable soldier boy as he marches up the line.
Colors so gay, walking the streets every day, singing
Tooralai, Ooralai, Ooralai, hey.
Fellas who've met her will never forget her, she has their hearts all in a whirl.
Nellie O'Morgan with her barrel organ,
the Irish Italian girl.
It's the same old song they sing, I love you. The boys are all mad about Nellie, the daughter of Officer Kelly. and it's all day long they'll bring flowers all dripping with dew. And we'll join in the chorus of Nelly Kelly, I love you. Oh, the night that Paddy Murphy died was the night I'll never forget. All the boys got roaring drunk and some ain't sober yet. And as long as the bottle was passed around, the lads were feeling gay. And O'Leary came with his bagpipes, the music for to play. Mrs. Murphy in the corner was pouring out her grief when Kelly and the lads, the dirty robbing thieves, they crept into the ante room and a bottle of whiskey stole. And they placed the bottle on the corpse to keep the liquor cold. And that's how they pay their respects to Paddy Murphy. That's how they show their honour and their pride. They said it was a sin and a shame, and they winked at one another. And everything in the wake house went the night Pat Murphy died.
It was early in the morning when the funeral left the house, and everyone but poor old Mrs. Murphy was half soused. We made a stop along the way at the Blarney Stone Saloon. We went in there at 9 o'clock and we didn't leave till noon. Then someone asked old Mulligan if anyone had died. Well, says he, I'm not quite sure, I just came for the ride. We started for the graveyard then, all walking in a line. But when we reached the grave we found we'd left the corpse behind.
And that's how they pay their respects to Paddy Murphy. That's how they show their honour and their pride. They said it was a sin and a shame, and they winked at one another. And everything in the wake house went the night Pat Murphy died. Of a few verses I'm now going to prattle. The night I got into a terrible battle, as sure as me life it puts me on me mettle. The night of the wedding of Lottie McGrath,
Harrowby Gart was a terrible tear. Me and McGrath, me mother was there. And if I get caught up with the wheels of the train, I may never go to a wedding again.
Well, the first to come in, it was old Mrs. Russell. She couldn't sing well, so she started to whistle, and somebody gave her a belt in the bustle. The night of the wedding, the Lottie McGrath.
The last to come in, it was old Jim McGinty. He stood in the door and he started to shinty. He took up a poker and sure he killed 20. The night of the wedding of Lottie McGrath,
Araby Gart was a terrible tear. Me and McGrath, me mother was there. And if I get caught up with the wheels of a train, I may never go to a wedding again.
There's many a man who rode a horse across the western plain. There's never been one like the Irishman, O'Sullivan was the name. He never carried a shooting iron, the need he never felt. With two shillelaghs always there, a hanging from his belt.
Yippee-ki-yi-yo, me bucko, be garahan, yippee-ki-yo. Two shillelaghs, O'Sullivan, he give any man a go.
A throwing a rope for Brandon calves, he was a mighty man. A drawing his two shillelaghs now, the fastest in the land. 'Twould be a sad mistake, me boy, to reach for a 44. Before you could have the hammer cocked, he'd have you on the floor.
Yippee-ki-yi-yo, me bucko, be garahan, yippee-ki-yo. Two shillelaghs, O'Sullivan, he'd give any man a go.
It's now to conclude and to finish my ditty. If ever friendless Irishman chances my way, with the best in the house. I will greet him in welcome at home on the green fields of Amherst.